we want to find the maximum and minimum values of the function f of x equals 4x squared minus 10x plus 8 on the closed interval from 0 to 5. The directions may also say find the absolute extrema on the closed interval. To do this, we'll first find the critical numbers of the function on the open interval. Then step 2, we'll evaluate the function at each critical number. Step 3, we'll evaluate the function at the endpoints of the closed interval. And then step 4, the least of these values is the minimum or absolute minimum, and the greatest is the maximum or absolute maximum. So we'll begin by determining the critical numbers by finding the first derivative and determining where it's equal to 0 or undefined. So f prime of x would be equal to the derivative of 4x squared, that would be 8x, and minus the derivative of 10x, which would be 10, and the derivative of 8 would be 0. Notice how we have a linear function here, which will never be undefined, so to find the critical number, we'll set this equal to 0 and solve for x. So we'd add 10 to both sides, that would give us 8x equals 10, divide both sides by 8. We have x equals 10 eighths, or 5 fourths, in simplified form. So we have one critical number. So now we evaluate the original function at the critical number x equals 5 fourths and at the endpoints of 0 and 5. So we'll have f of 5 fourths, f of 0, and f of 5. The smallest of these values will be the minimum, and the largest of these values will be the maximum. Let's go and evaluate these using the graphing calculator. First, we'll enter the function into y1, so we'll press y equals, enter the function, 4x squared minus 10x plus 8. And now we'll go back to the home screen. So second mode for quit. And now we'll enter y1 of 5 fourths, y1 of 0, and y1 of 5. So we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and now in parentheses, 5 fourths, and enter. So f of 5 fourths is equal to 1.75, or as a fraction we can press math, enter, enter, at 7 fourths. So f of 5 fourths is equal to 7 fourths. F of 0, we can see, would just be 0 minus 0 plus 8, or 8. And then for f of 5, again we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and in parentheses 5. Of course, we could also evaluate these by hand if we wanted to. So f of 5 is equal to 58. Notice how the smallest function value is 7 fourths. This is the minimum value, and the largest value is 58, which would be the maximum value of this function on the closed interval. So we'll say the absolute minimum, or the minimum value, is 7 fourths at x equals 5 fourths, and the absolute maximum, or the maximum value, is 58 at x equals 5. Let's go and take a look at the graph of our function on this closed interval to verify these results. Notice the largest function value on this closed interval is 58, which occurs at x equals 5, and the smallest function value, which is hard to tell on this graph, would be here, which is 7 fourths, which occurs at 5 fourths. So this graph does verify our results. I hope you found this helpful.